What is going on? We are here with the Insonic ASR 10. Super powerful, top of the line sampler from Insonic, the now defunct company. And just a heads up, if you really want to get into the ins and outs of this thing and understand how powerful this sampler actually is, the Insonic manual is for you. Information in the description box below. And we're going to get into some things with the ASR 10 that just really puts it over the edge in terms of versatility. But before we get started, I want to let you know that episode 55 of the Samplers Podcast is live right now. When you're finished with this video, head on over and check that out. Info in the description box below. Also, the days are counting down. 7 days to go until the release of History Never Gets Old. My new album releasing on December 5th. You can get your pre-orders for the cassette today. And look, we have colors, oh yeah, more colors. In the way of cassettes, you're never going to know what color you get. This is a complete custom-made physical offering. Info in the description box below. Now, on to what we're going to look into with this sampler here. Now, there's many ways that you can play your sequences and get inspiration for versatility in your sounds. And one of them is to create a format where you can make a wavetable for your drums. So instead of just playing traditionally your drums, like you have your snare, your hi-hat, whatever, you play them, you know, individually in order to make a sequence. Right now, we're going to go over a concept of splicing your drums together so you could make a palette of drums to choose from. So we'll start with what I did here. Initially, I had these snare sounds that I wanted to work with, so I'll just play them right now. Right, so those are all the snare sounds. Now, in order to make a sequence out of them, I can play them just like how I did. I could play one and then move over to the next track and play another, and then so on or so forth. Or I could put them all on one track and play them like a drum kit, standard stuff. An alternative way is to put them all spliced up together and then use the powerful synthesis algorithms that the ASR 10 has, specifically transwaves, to line them up and be able to modulate through them at any point I want. So what I ended up doing was putting them all on one track and splice them all together. So check out how they play. Right, so now all four, I think it's four. Yep, all four are played back to back. Now I can use transwaves to modulate between them. And because transwaves modulates by equal parts, all I have to do is measure the length of each drum, make them all the same length, and then I can choose between them any way I want. The second thing I have to do once they're playing in this order is choose something to modulate them by. And of course, the easiest thing to use is the modulation wheel. So check out how this works out now. Okay, so we're here at the modulation wheel. I've turned transwaves on, and now what's going to happen is I can use this mod wheel to scroll through my options of snares and choose which one I want to listen to. So check this out. This is amazing. So not only can I do that, when I sequence a pattern using this style of drum method, I can now choose live on the fly which drum I want to use. I can also use an independent modulator like an LFO to scroll through the drums. So I've also done this with a kick. So let's take a listen to that. And I've also done with a hi-hat. So now we can go ahead and make music, and we know that we can choose whatever combination we want to. So I've just made a sequence, and let's see what that sounds like. All right, so I'm just gonna start things up, and then as we do this, I'm gonna scroll through the mod wheel, and we'll see what happens. All right, yes, the beat is kind of sloppy, I'm lazy, but the power of this is that you can choose anything and modulate anything in a wavetable. And I've just used four drums here, but you could put an entire drum kit if you want to spend the time back to back to modulate through and make it very, very accurate, especially when you're modulating with something other than the wheel. You can make some crazy, crazy combinations. And this works really well at fast tempos because your choices get so quick that they really sound interesting when you do things. Not to mention, you can add filters on top of this, effects on top of this, anything you want to make it really sound insane. It's an incredible tool that I highly recommend you try in your music. Just for subtle things, even variations between snares. You could have the same snare or the same sound and just have subtle differences between the two, and you could have them modulate and choose between each other on the fly as you're working. So even for subtle things like that, it's a really amazing benefit to the creative process. Anyway, that is all I wanted to share with you today. Remember to get your pre-order of History Never Gets Old, as well as mark your calendars for December 5th. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.